Hi, my name is Karin. Welcome to your Pilates and Slings bedtime story. What you need is a mat and a longish kind of belt. I'm using a yoga belt. That's ideal. If you have one, place that near your mat. And then two other things. Softish ball is a bonus, but you don't need one. And the pillow is an option if you like one. So we'll start the sequence in a high kneeling position. So by the way, if you find distress quite spaced out, it's all part of the story. Space, stars, limitless possibilities, sweet dreams. So it's a whole story. So knees hip distance and parallel or a little bit wider. You choose whatever makes it easy to center your pelvis and elongate the spine. Take your arms out to the side. Inhale. And with your exhalation, a round back. So a long arch to the back, big circle with your arms. Inhalation, open. Back to the starting position. Exhalation into a round back, big circle with the arms. And then inhalation, lifting back up. As you exhale, you're drawing up from your pelvic floor, draw back from your abdominals. Inhalation, slowly let go. So an active stretch for your back, opening the back of the spine, and then keep a sense of openness when you come up one more time. Exhalation into a big circle, big arch, round back. Inhale at the top. Exhalation, side sit. And then inhale, lift back up. So in your side sit, the spine stays really long and you're shifting one side of your pelvis to one side. The side of the hips are lengthening and getting strengthened. So it's a really nice way to release the abductors a little bit before going to bed. One more time, side sit. And then stay at the top, side bend. Inhalation into a side bend, really long. And then exhalation, let the breath take you back. Inhalation is length and opening up the side of the body. And then as the ribs close with the exhalation, you center. One more time to your right. The left side is opening up. And then softly closing. One more time to the left. Into side bend and then center. Now I'll combine the three movements. Let the breath flow. So side bend combined with a side sit round back leads to a big spiraling movement reverse to come back up. So side bend, sit, round back, spiraling down and back up. You can let the breath flow or you can exhale into the spiraling movement down. Inhalation to center the body. Now, spiraling movements, they can beautifully lift the energy, but they can also ground the energy. And this spiral is a grounding the energy spiral. One more time. Take a seat on the side of your legs. Take the legs to the front. Sit a little bit forward on your mat so you have enough mat behind you so you can roll down. Feet hip distance and parallel. Hold on behind the knees. If you like, you can close the legs. Draw the heels towards you so your spine is elongating. And then roll back. Draw up from your lower abdominals, pelvic floor. Let the breath flow. Slide the feet along the mat on your sacrum and then imprint one vertebra at a time softly into the mat. Hug the knees towards you, completely relax, engage again, bring your knees away from the chest, lift your head, draw back from your abdominals, extend your legs 45 degrees forward, bend the knees and roll forward. It's called a spine stretch position. So once again, stretch for the back, roll up. And again, with your exhalation, engage your pelvic floor, abdominals, roll back, slide the feet along the mat, let the breath flow onto the sacrum, and then imprinting one vertebra at a time into the mat, super soft, completely relax. And then engage one more time, knees away from the chest, head off the floor, shoulders off the floor, extend the legs briefly. Let your feet touch the floor softly, roll forwards into that long stretch, and then curl up. one more time. So with that sense of openness through the spine, roll down one more time. Slide the feet along the mat. Roll all the way down into a rest position. Hug the knees towards the chest and then move your knees away from the chest into a tabletop position. Take your arms up towards the ceiling and then relax your arms on the floor. Lower the heels. Place one foot after the other on the floor, so fairly close to your sit bones. I'm taking my arms further out so it's more easily visible what I'm doing. Let the pelvis sink back. Let the lower back melt into the floor and then lift the pelvis off the floor. Peel the spine away from the mat, one bone at a time. So peeling the spine away into a shoulder bridge. Hold the position. Lengthen out of the knees. Connect your sit bones with the knees. Draw up from your pubic bone. Take your arms overhead. You can take them all the way back or keep them above the floor. And then start to roll down. So one more time, lengthening the back extensor spinal muscles and also shoulder muscles. So getting that openness and softness through the back. And then circle your arms to the front. Rest your arms on the floor. Take one leg up into a tabletop position and then towards the chest. Hug it really close. Now it's time for the belt. So the belt has a loop. And then loop the belt around the foot. It's a really divine exercise. You could also loop it around the knee. And then place the belt around the upper part of your head like so. Or you're looping the belt around the foot, bending the knee, so you can loop the belt around the back of your head. So it needs to be a really comfortable height for your head, otherwise just lengthen the belt a little bit. Now, relaxing the back of the head into the belt, you can extend the leg a little bit more, slide the other one out so the front of the hip is opening, and then you can enjoy this most amazing position for as long as you like with your knee bent, back of your head just melting into that belt. The neck is lengthening, it's very, very relaxing. Or you can extend the leg, the one you're stretching. For a moment, lift your head up a little bit higher. Front is soft, back is lengthening, and then melt into that leg stretch. So the weight of the head is assisting the stretch. You could just stay in that position and enjoy it for as long as you like, or you can add a little movement. It's like a pendulum movement of the leg, and then you let the head roll with the pendulum movement of the leg, so from side to side, also very relaxed. It's very hard to get out, but at one point we need to get out, so that point is now. So bend the knee. You can lift the head a little bit more. Take the loop away from the head, relax your head, shoulders back down, and then hold on to the belt and just add a little bit of a pendulum movement. If you have a ball or you have a pillow, place the pillow next, or the ball next to the hip, and then you can take the leg out to the side with the belt, but the leg or the hip is actually resting on the prop. So right now for me, I can let my leg rest on the ball and then just add a very small up-down movement of the leg using the belt. So it's really nice as well. And then lift the leg back up. Take it across the body once towards you so you can take the belt away from the foot and then slide the leg away from the body and just for a moment feel how that feels in one side of the body compared to the other side of the body. To the other side, so bend the knee, loop the belt around the foot, or the knee. Then lifting the head, placing the belt around the back of the head. Again, extending the leg a little bit more so the knee is slightly bent, and we just let, in that position, we let the body just be for a moment. So there's a softening, there is a relaxing, there's a deep breath. It's a little bit of a, what I call a lava breath, so it's very deep, going all the way down into the belly. And then if you like, you can extend the leg for a short moment, press the leg away, a little bit engaging, more lengthening to the back of the neck, and then let the weight of the head rest in the loop and aid the leg stretch. And then once again, you can stay for as long as you like. It's just a beautiful stretch, it's divine. You can add a little bit of movement, which is equally beautiful, allowing the head to roll from side to side. And then finishing in the center. Just one more time, letting go. And then you can lift the head a little bit further up, bend the knee. Take the belt away from behind the head. Hold on to the belt. If you used a ball or a pillow on one side, use it on the other side. So again, you wedge it in just underneath the hip, and then take the leg out to the side and let it rest on that prop. And if you like, if it feels really nice, you can add a little bit of movement using the belt, changing the way you stretch, creating a little bit of glide. And then lift the leg back up, take it across the body, back to the center. Then bend the knee, take the belt away, the ball away, slide the leg out. And then just let the body absorb and let your system get really, really calm. Beautiful. Well, I don't want to get up, but at one point, if this is not right near your bed, you will have to get up. So slide the legs towards you, hug the knees close. And then roll your legs to one side, over the side, coming up into a sitting position. And if your bed is right there, have a great night's sleep.